Patrick, and we're back with part 5. Join us as we go from Colorado sand dunes to the Ozark National Forest in Arkansas. We had the campsite until 11 a.m., so our plan was to pack out the camp, go down to the Medano Creek, and make the most of it until it was time to leave. The Medano Creek in May was truly a recreational oasis. But no matter how long we wanted to stay, we had a lot of ground to cover if we wanted to make it to Arkansas the following day. We're not getting anything done sitting in this creek playing around. With our campsite fully packed out, we set our final goodbyes and set our sights on Arkansas. This was an extinct volcano named the Capulin Monument. Here we stopped for dinner on the border of Texas and New Mexico at a town called Texline. It was around 1 a.m. when I decided to finally pull the car over and take a rest. We couldn't make it out of Oklahoma. By the time we woke up, we had made it to Arkansas within the hour. might not believe it, but I was excited to be back to the eastern woodlands of the United States. It wasn't up until this point that I realized I was homesick. We're in the Ozark National Forest in Arkansas. And the water is blue. That is so cool. But there's two poisonous snakes here, the copperhead and the water moccasin. And they love murky water, so. So we got the same exact camp spot as the Outdoor Boys. Yeah. Arkansas, without a doubt, was one of the most unique places I've ever been, and I never felt more at home. So if you watch The Outdoor Boys, he does an episode where it's the longest road trip in America. But when he's in the Ozarks, he camps at this spot and hurts his butt going down the slide. Or not the slide, the waterfall. It's just funny. We got this campsite, so shout out to The Outdoor Boys. It's a cacophony of insects and toads and whatever else. When I've been away for too long, the only thing on my mind is finding a way back home. If you enjoy this video, please consider subscribing and joining along for more adventures. Thank you for watching.